Why is Doug not here tonight? Anyway, no, that's a different story. Yes, take a look at this map behind me. These are the dates of the earliest date where we hit 32 degrees, actually below 32 degrees. And one of these things is not like the other. You see, it took until October for the earliest date in Reading. In Lancaster, October 12th. That's tomorrow. And we hit that in 1996. That's when we got below 32 for the first time, the earliest date in Lancaster. And I think we're going to get very close to this again tomorrow. We actually have a freeze watch in effect for the overnight Friday into Saturday morning. So let's take a look at the forecast in Reevestown, Lancaster County, and the rest of the Susquehanna Valley. Partly cloudy, chilly tonight, 38 to 42. We're going to see a little bit more in the way of clouds as we head towards the morning, and then that will give way to sun in the afternoon. Might even see a sprinkle around tomorrow morning, a little bit of a raw start to the day. 56 to 60, a little cooler tomorrow compared to today, also breezier, so it's going to feel cooler out there. You'll need a little bit of a thicker jacket compared to what you had this afternoon. Saturday, though, we get back up to about where we were today. Similar weather Saturday as we had earlier this afternoon. Now currently 38 already in Elizabethville, Northern Dauphin County, Newville as well, 44 in New Bloomfield, 48 in Harrisburg and Hershey. Those are the warm spots in the map with Gettysburg. And as we go to the east side of the river, you see a 48 in Palmyra, 39 though in Myerstown. Clear skies helping to bring down those temperatures quite quickly in the early part of the overnight. Nothing here in Super Doppler 8 to show you when we look at the satellite radar composite. Just a couple high clouds starting to filter in across the central parts of the valley. We pan back and take a look just a couple hundred miles off the east coast here of Florida. This is Tropical Storm Patty. Not going to affect our weather at all, actually drifting on its way out to sea. What will affect our weather, though, is this cold front. You can see it stretching now from just north Chicago through Michigan into southern Canada. This is moving towards us, but as it heads into the state, it's going to kind of stretch out and lose a bunch of its punch. Now, it's going to bring some cold air behind it, but not much in the way of showers. You're going to see that here in the News 8 predictor. There's our cold front, the blue line on the map. High pressure in command right now. That's going to relinquish its hold as we go through the overnight. And we'll stop it here. 8 o'clock in the morning, you see clouds thick in western Pennsylvania, also thickening across the valley. And that's where I think we see a possible little sprinkle move through 8 to about 12 noon. But look how quickly this moves through. Clouds dissipate quickly. By 6 o'clock tomorrow, cold air is rushing down in out of Canada. That's going to set us up for that cold night I was talking about earlier. Temperatures freezing or below could get down in the 20s in areas to the north and west of Harrisburg. So cold temperatures, and then high pressure slides off the coast. Warm air comes up from the south. That's going to give us some more tropical air. You'll see that here as our we go through our predictor. Temperatures in the middle 50s tomorrow, but there are those cold temperatures early in the morning on Saturday. So in review, it's a cloudy start tomorrow. It stays cool pretty much through Saturday with a frosty Saturday morning where we will be at freezing or below into those early morning hours. And 62 for a high on Saturday, a little bit warmer as we go into the day on Sunday. Rest of the 7 day in the mid to upper 60s, returns to more seasonal temperatures. So little preview.
A teaser
of winter coming in the early part of this weekend.
I'm not ready for fall. Yeah. Keep winter on the back burner. Thanks so much, Matt.